And we are happy to have right now Barnes and Noble's Nook e-readers leader. It is just one part of the company's digital strategy, which is, of course, central to the bookseller. Today, William Lynch was named Barnes and Noble's new CEO. He's formerly the head of the company's website and .com business. He will push the increased integration with retail locations, and he joins me right now in an exclusive interview. It is great to have you on the program.
Thank you for having me.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You just got the news, when, last night, this morning? This is big news for you.
Well, we just announced this morning, that's right. As you can imagine, we've been in discussions for some time about this, but I'm really honored to be leading this great company, especially during the transformation more to Barnes & Noble as a digital and technology company.
Well, that's the thing. I mean, Jim, just to give us his report on the big battle going on in terms of pricing for e-readers, tell me about that. How do you see the playing field shaking out?
Well, we think there will be a shakeout in e-books, and there will be a few companies that are offering e-books to consumers. Barnes & Noble, we've had a lot of success so far selling digital content. On our last earnings call, we talked about, I think the term we used was the explosive growth we're seeing in ebooks, and certainly that's true. Now that we've rolled out Nook in our stores, where we reach millions of readers, we've seen the sell-through of both our Nook device and also our ebooks through software for other mobile products really drive penetration for ebooks. So we're certainly planning for that to be a growth business and are calibrating our investments accordingly.
Do you think pricing is under pressure with the competition out there? I mean, the Nook has been very successful, but you've got the Kindle, you've got, you know, wannabes out there around you, you've got Sony. So does pricing come down?
On e-readers?
Yeah,
we think there'll be, if you look at the e-reader market, there'll be e-reader specific devices like Nook and like others, and then there'll be multifunctional devices that have e-reading capability, some of which we power. Last week, we announced that the Samsung reader will connect to the Barnes & Noble e-book store. You'll see an announcement on other devices, which we call multifunctional devices, that'll have e-reading capability where Barnes & Noble will power those bookstores. So we think there'll be pressure down overall on e-reader, dedicated e-reader pricing, certainly, but we also see all kinds of other devices which employ e-reader capability for consumers.
I think it was Eric Schmidt who told me, and I love this stat, I've said it a number of times actually, that there are 4 billion mobile devices in the world versus 1 billion PCs. Right there, you can see where things are going. It's mobility, and people want their information and data all on that device, whether it's an e-reader or something else. So you've said electronic sales and digital books will be the key to your future. Does that mean you're going to cut back on retail sales? How do you do this integration?
Well, we think, in fact, our retail stores are a unique asset that we have, and we plan to leverage those just as we have with Nook. I mean, they've been our most powerful sales and marketing channel. Barnes & Noble, as you know, is a leading bookstore chain, and we reach more readers in our brick-and-mortar stores than anyone. So there will be a consolidation of bookstores in the country. We think we'll be the beneficiary of that. We've been gaining share in the brick-and-mortar retail business for quite some time, and we think with that consolidation, we will continue to benefit. We don't plan on, if you look at our store count, what we said in the next 2 years, we see our store count remaining about flat.
So you're the big gorilla when it comes to books, there's no doubt about it, but Apple seems to be the big gorilla when it comes to devices and online. Apple is going to begin selling digital books in its stores through iBookstore for use on the iPad. So how do you keep going and make change and innovation to stay on top and gain an edge on competitors like Apple?
We, first of all, we partner with Apple in that we offer the Barnes & Noble e-reader software on Apple products. I think we've had over 1 million downloads of our Barnes & Noble e-reader for iPhone. And we announced last week, Maria, that we'll have a Barnes & Noble e-book app for the iPad as well. Certainly, they're a formidable competitor, but they're also a partner of ours.
That's good.
And again, I think, you know, with our stores and our ability to reach readers that no one else has, we think we'll be quite successful in this area.
What are you seeing in terms of the consumer right now? You've got a great vantage point on that end, certainly with all the retail stores. Where are we in the recovery from the consumer standpoint?
We think we're starting to see a flattening and potentially, you know, we certainly see store traffic looking better than it did 6 months ago. Mm-hmm. So that's encouraging. And you know, we don't think there'll be the kind of growth we saw 2 years ago, 2.5 years ago, retail. But we certainly see that we're starting to see some recovery signs.
So when you look at your agenda going forward now, beginning of the new role as CEO of the company, coming from .com, what's number one or number two on your list of most important things to do at this point?
Well, I think other than talent, we've added a lot of talent in the last 6 months, specifically in the technology area, laying out a strategy where we'll invest in technology, both our online shopping channel, BN.com, as well as our digital products and ebooks. It's really leveraging our multi-channel assets and doing that in a way that's compelling and delivers unique experiences to the customer. As an example, our reserve online pickup in store program has seen explosive growth, where you can go on the site, check in stock for a book at your local Barnes & Noble, and that bookseller will set it aside for you so you can pick it up within 30 minutes. That continues to be extremely popular. So we'll look for more programs like that that leverage our pervasive footprint and deliver interesting experiences for customers.
What about the commercial side of things? Barnes & Noble is often an anchor store in terms of commercial property developments, right? And here we are having this worry out there that we're going to see a bust in the commercial real estate market. Is that affecting the company in any way that you can talk to us about the upset or the anticipation that we're going to see some weakness in commercial real estate?
Well, if anything, we see it as a bit of an opportunity. I mean, Mitch Clipper and our retail team are some of the most seasoned retail operators in the country. The way we've structured our leases, they're shorter term than most other retailers. Are also in what we think are some of the best locations. So as we see softness in the real estate market, we see that as an opportunity to look at those stores and ensure profitability out of those stores.
All right, Bill, we hope you'll come back and give us a progress report. Tell us how things are going. We appreciate you joining us on day one of the announcement.
Well, thank you for having me.
Thanks so much.
I will sure do that.
William Lynch.